Welcome back. You are watching the 700 Club. Man, we've got a bunch of stuff today. We've gone from Alzheimer's to heaven. And heaven, that's where we want to go there. Paul said, I'll do anything I could that I may attain the resurrection of the just. And we all want to know what it's going to be like. Well, take a look.
You might recognize Dr. Robert Jeffers as a Fox News contributor. He also pastors a 13,000-member church in Dallas, Texas. Dr. Jeffers says throughout his frequent travels around the world, he thinks about one trip that will last for eternity. In his book, A Place Called Heaven, he shares why it's important for all of us to focus on heaven and how thinking about the next life can make us more effective in this one.
Well, it's a fascinating book. It's called, A Place Called Heaven. Dr. Robert Jeffress has written it, and he's with us right now. Robert, good to have you with us. God bless you.
Thank you, Pat, for having me.
All right, look, where's heaven?
Well,
how about that?
That's a great question, and a lot of people are really mixed up about that, Pat,
all right,
because one of the questions I answer is, do we immediately go to heaven when we die? Yeah. The short answer is we go immediately into the presence of the Lord. 2 Corinthians 5:8, to be absent from the body is to be at home with the Lord. So we're conscious, we're awake, we know what's happening, but that's not our ultimate destination.
Right.
Ultimately, we're going to spend eternity right here on this recreated earth, just as God intended it to be. The New Jerusalem comes down out of heaven, down to earth, and this is where we're going to be instead of floating around up there in some foreign planet.
I kind of like that.
Yes.
We talk so much about the rapture, people getting caught up out of here, but really, what you're saying is that heaven will be a recreated earth.
That's right. And that's what John said in Revelation 21. I saw a new heaven
and a new earth.
And, you know, that's the interesting thing, Pat. When we die,
we
don't become somebody else in heaven. It is we who die. We are the ones who go to heaven. We retain our names. We retain our personalities. I think even some of the same gifts that we have right now are going to extend throughout eternity so that we have something to do in the new heaven and earth.
Well, let's talk about what are we going to do? I mean, people think, well, I'm going to sit around on a cloud playing a harp all the day. That's not it at all.
Or let's face it, Pat, some people think heaven is going to be one long, unending church service, and that sounds more like hell to people than heaven.
That's much fun as it leg cramp.
And look, we've got to be honest. We are going to worship in heaven, but we're going to do more than worship. We're going to work in heaven and on this new earth. God made us to be workers. He created us to work. It's not a curse. It's a gift from God. We're going to work on the new earth. And I wouldn't be surprised, Pat, if our work in the new heaven and new earth doesn't resemble what we do right now.
Well, you know,
I mean, you're a great entrepreneur.
That's right.
You're a tremendous broadcaster. I don't think God just limited those gifts for right now. You may be hosting the heavenly edition of the 700 Club. Who knows?
Can you imagine? For all eternity.
For all eternity.
Well, you know, Paul said we'll judge the angels. So do you think there's going to be a time, a big tribunal where the saints of God will be doing that?
I think for some people, there will be judgments. I think for some people, we're going to be ruling and reigning with Christ, 2 Timothy 2. I think we'll be creating new things in heaven. I think there's all kind of responsibilities that will be given to us, by the way, based on our faithfulness to Christ in this life. And this is one of the things I talk about in A Place Called Heaven. As brief as our life is here on earth compared to eternity, what we do in these few short years has eternal consequences. What we do on earth reverberates in the halls of heaven forever.
People have asked me about, you know, the idea of you know, a baby. He dies when he's a year old, and the thought would be that he's matured up to about 30 or something, and people in their 80s or 90s come back to 30. What age do you think is there, if we're spirits, it really doesn't matter, huh?
It's pure conjecture of what our age is going to be. Some people say 30 because that's when Christ began his ministry. It's just conjecture, but the good news is we are who we were here on earth. Did you know, Pat, for example, we're going to retain our names in heaven.
Yeah.
I mean, Moses and Elijah, they'd been dead for hundreds of years, but when they came back with Christ on the Mount of Transfiguration, they were Moses and Elijah. They weren't somebody else. So we retain our names. We're going to have bodies, by the way. People ask, do we know one another in heaven?
Mm-hmm.
Absolutely. I mean, our bodies are going to be like Jesus Christ in His resurrection body. His disciples knew Him. Not only that, Jesus ate in His new resurrection body.
Yeah.
So the best news for a lot of people is we're going to eat in heaven.
Yeah.
That's absolutely true.
But always in moderation. Okay. What do you think about people? Why are there so many misconceptions about heaven? I mean, what happens when we die, for example? When do we go to heaven?
Well, 2 Corinthians 5:8, immediately we go to be with the Lord. There's no such thing in the Bible, Pat, as soul sleep.
Yeah. Or
that is a man-made concept. We go immediately to be with the Lord. And I think the misconceptions come about because many people, and even many Christians,
mm-hmm.
get their ideas about heaven from Hollywood,
yeah.
the movies or TV, or some of these fanciful books that have been written about heaven. I base my book, A Place Called Heaven, on what the Bible teaches.
Mm-hmm.
Because the Bible has a lot to say about heaven.
It sure does.
And you know, one of the questions, Pat, people have is, well, why even talk about heaven? With all that's going on in the world, hurricanes,
mm-hmm.
a conflict with North Korea, shouldn't we be thinking about this world instead of the next world? And yet, isn't this a perfect time to be talking about heaven?
Best of all.
To remind us that this world is not all that there is. God has something better for us.
What do you think we're going to be, what do you think we're going to be doing? Jesus talked about a reward. He said they will
yes.
not lose their reward. He'll get the reward of a prophet and so forth.
Yes.
Well, what kind of rewards do you think there are?
That is a great question. And I spend a whole chapter talking about, will heaven be the same for everybody? A lot
mm-hmm.
of people think heaven is going to be kind of a sanctified socialism where we all get the same size house and the same plot of land and so forth. No, the Bible says there are degrees of heaven
yes.
based on our faithfulness to Christ in this life. And while our good works have absolutely nothing to do with securing our place in heaven,
mm-hmm.
good works make a lot of difference after we're saved. And they determine the kind of heaven we experience. I think those rewards, the Bible refers to them as crowns, but I think they refer to special privileges. For example,
mm-hmm.
the Bible talks about special access to the tree of life, special positions, special praise we'll hear from God.
Mm-hmm.
Well done, good
yeah.
and faithful servant. Whatever these rewards are, Paul said they are worth sacrificing for.
Mm-hmm.
And again, you know, when people do small things here on earth, they reverberate in heaven forever. Giving the Operation Blessing, for example, that is something we do right here on earth, but there are rewards we receive in heaven for doing these things.
You know, the Apostle Paul said, we'll all stand before the bema, the judgment
yes.
seat of Christ, to receive the things that we've done in our body. Talk about that.
Yeah, that's one of the misconceptions people have, that if we're a Christian, we never have to face the judgment of God.
Yeah.
It's true we never face God's condemnation. Our sins have been forgiven.
Yeah.
But we will experience God's evaluation
mm-hmm.
of our life. And what you talk about, the judgment seat of Christ, is talking about that. Paul was talking to Christians, we must all appear before that judgment seat of Christ. And 1 Corinthians 3 says, if our works are seen to be wood, hay, and stubble,
yeah.
we will suffer loss. Pat, there's going to be real measurable loss as we see what could have been ours had we not been, if we had been more faithful. The good news is to our audience is there's still time right now to make a change in your life. If you're not living for Christ as a Christian, you can make a change that really will make an eternal difference in that place called heaven.
Brother, you hit the nail right on the head. God bless you. A Place Called Heaven, Dr. Robert Jeffress. This is a sound book, ladies and gentlemen. You really ought to get a copy of it. Where do they get these things?
The book's available in all Christian bookstores and all secular bookstores or at Amazon.com.
Okay.
And it's a great encouragement, by the way, to those who may be facing heaven soon
sure.
as well.
Well, God bless you. It's a wonderful analysis, and I appreciate your being here. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much, Pat.
God bless you. Well, we can also hear more from Dr. Jeffress today in an exclusive interview on our Facebook page. So be sure to check that out.